Hello guys, NeonGrey101 back, and this time I'm reviewing the Panasonic Lumix. And like I said in my last video, I said I was going to do it sometime today or this week, so today I finally got the chance to do it, and I figured why not, I'll do it. So this is it, this is the camera, what I'm using right now, like this camera, what you've seen. So yeah, so pretty much it looks basic, and it that's what it is. It's, of course, it comes with the camera too, and obvious, and plus the transfer cable right here. Of course, I keep it pretty much right in this case, which is very small, and I really don't like it, but this will have to do. Comes with the CD. And of course, it comes with QuickTime, which some the CDs do. Of course, I don't like the software on this. You can find better video software, like who knows, maybe iMovie's better or Windows Movie Maker. But I don't know if that. I don't know. You can find other ones better than the Lumix application. And then it comes with instructions. Oh wait, this is just the receipt that I got from H.H. Gregg, never mind. Then, oh yeah, here it is, here's the instruction. Yeah, of course it comes with English, Spanish, and French, all in one. But, you know, that's pretty much it for this camera, you know, nothing to display here. Not much to display. No, it's just very, very basic. Okay. Now, here are my pros on this one. This is very good. And that's what I like about the camera. That it's very simple to use. I mean, you don't need to use anything technically advanced. You know, right now, I'm using the standard definition on this camera right now. I could switch to HD if I wanted to, but I choose not to because which is gonna be a lot of memory, and also I have to delete my last video, which I already made a few minutes ago. So I don't want to do that. But of course, I'll tell you though, memory. Well, I did say the first one was simple to use, but of course, easy to scroll around. You know, you got your displays, and you can control the flash. And plus the exposure on this one, I love it, you know. So, which makes it a good start for anyone that wants a camera. This camera was on sale, actually, not too long ago, about 2 weeks ago. It was only $60 in HH Gregg. I like it. So, if you have a store, HH Gregg store close to you, I mean, it's worth it. Just for the price. I mean, $60. I mean, you can't go wrong. So, it was great. Of course, I believe this one holds up to 16 gigabytes or 32 gigabytes. I might be wrong, but who knows? I think you can go higher than that. But all in all, that's it. So, but here's our my cons. On this camera, even though you can go up on high definition, this takes 720, which is the highest on this camera, and which is alright. I mean, then again, the 1080 cameras are a little bit expensive, so but if you're going for a high definition camera for your start, this is something that you might want to consider. So this is not 1080, but believe me, this will work for you only unless you're starting your own video blog, YouTubing. So otherwise, that's about it. And also the problem with this is that here are only a few features that I've noticed that maybe at night when you're maybe when you're taking pictures at night, it's just me, but you just don't, you just can't focus that well when you're taking shots at night, and you need to brighten the exposure of it. So that's something I have to test it out. It's something I need to work on, experiment a little bit, but something I really can't say bad about much. But if I have to, I would have to give it a 7, you know, because just because of the price. I mean, heck, if I could I have given it an 8, sure I could have, but a 7 is a good score. But you know, it's not gonna be all perfect, you know, from what I've seen with other cameras. I mean, I've started off YouTube with a 7 megapixel camera. This right here is a 14 megapixel camera, and that's how I started it off. And you know, the definition wasn't the best, but you know what, it was a good start, including this one. And I'm using the 480 because I don't want to take too much memory. Plus, high definition videos takes a lot of memory. Unless you have the memory for that, then yeah, you might want to go ahead and consider it. So overall, good camera, no doubt about it. So, and unlike other ones, some may have Wi-Fi, some may have Bluetooth built in, so that way you don't have to carry the cables with you around when you're traveling, you know. But it's good. So that's it. So that's my first tech review of my channel. We'll take care, guys. Love to hear your responses and see what you think. So if this camera is not perfect for you, then I don't know what else. You know, there's better cameras out there than Panasonic, believe me. There's Nikon, there's Samsung, so. But this will work for anyone. Take care.